Okay, so levy and collection of tax. Alright, taxable event in GST is the supply. The discussion, whole all discussion on supply, and so many illustration at beginning we are going to discuss on supply only. Alright, some basic fundamental they have given, supply of goods and services. It should be for consideration, it should be in the course or furtherance of business, it should be made by taxable person, it should be taxable supply. Taxable supply means it should not be money, securities or alcoholic liquor for human consumption, and petroleum product also for that matter. Okay, supply should be made within the taxable territory, which is India, then only levy will be there, because GST extends to whole of India. So these are the points that they have discussed here. Exception, you know that import of service for a consideration without in a course of business can be taxable at 71B. And secondly, there are certain activities which are treated as supply, deemed as supply under section 71C, schedule 1, without consideration. So those two exceptions they have written here. Section 7 subsection 1 and section 7 subsection 2. Section 7 subsection 1 talks about what is supply, whereas section 7 subsection 2 talks about what is not supply. Okay, so that we will discuss. So this is old, they have deleted it, later let it be. Now new section is section 71A. Section 71A talks about what is supply of goods and what is supply of service. Yes or no? Yes. Alright, so that is schedule 2. They are just referring here. Now in the course of business, first point they are trying to explain us what is in the course of business. So let us see. Now your answer should be whether it is supply or it is not a supply. We are not going to discuss what is it, whether it is taxable or not taxable. We are talking whether it is supply or not a supply. And if it is supply, I want section. Under which section it is a supply? Alright, it can be supply either in 71A or in 71B or in 71C, not in any other case. Okay, one of these three sections you have to tell me. Okay, CMA Ram, a practicing cost accountant, carries on activity of accounting, auditing, filing of returns, certifying document and so on so forth. Come on, tell me. This is question. Is it supply? 71A. Why? Because two factors. It is in the course of business. And obviously he is a CMA, he is not doing as a charitable activity. He will be charging consideration for it. So this will be supply under section 71A. So can you write that there? This is supply. So these activities can be considered as a perform in the course of business, and therefore it is supply under section 71A. Am I clear? It is supply under section 71A. Easy? Okay. Next. So 71A is done. Next. Messes X Limited manufacturing motor cars. Company used to sell more number of cars in southern India. In view of demand in southern India, company intends to establish manufacturing unit in Chennai. Messes X Limited appointed Mr. Y as a consultant for searching, evaluating and shortlisting places for the prospective targets. Finally, company decided to establish unit in Ambattur Industrial Estate in Chennai. So tell me, Mr. Y, who was a consultant, is he carrying any activity which is in the course of business? Yes. Yes, for him it is the activity in the course of business. Will he do it for free?
No.
No. Consideration. See, if it is without consideration, they will clearly write it is without consideration. Till that time, we all have to assume it is for a consideration. So is it supply?
Yes.
Yes. That supply is again under?
718.
Okay. So Mr. Y is carrying out various activity in the furtherance of business of X Limited. Am I clear? So it is business activity, and because it is business activity, it is a supply. Supply can be of this type, yes or no? We have discussed in 71A. Such as, no? Supply can be of such as sale, transfer, barter, exchange, license, rental, lease or disposal of goods or services or both. Example 3. Mr. X sold a laptop worth rupees 1 lakh. And issued invoice in favor of Y. Now ownership of laptop is transferred to Y. Yes or no? Ownership is transferred. Invoice is made, means ownership is transferred. So sale. Whether sale is the supply?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, it is the supply. Taxable?
Yes.
Yes, because it is in the course or furtherance of business.
Yes.
And it is supply. Under section again 71A. Will there be levy of GST?
Yes.
Answer is yes. Okay, it is leviable. 71A. Right now, which section is going on, you must have understood. 7-1A. Because it is business activity, at the same time, there is a consideration. Okay? Next. Now, this is little confusing. Okay? Illegal activity and prohibited activity. So if you do illegal activity, government is going to take tax from you for sure. And if you do prohibited activity, then there won't be tax because the prohibited activity cannot be performed. What is the example they have given? Mr. T is some thief. He's stealing motor vehicle and selling motor vehicle. Is it legal act or illegal activity? If the government catches him while selling that bike, they are saying it is a supply and you must pay tax. Yes or no? Because you are doing illegal activity. So illegal activity is a business. In definition of business, it is clearly written illegal. Business can be legal or as well as illegal. But something which is prohibited, you cannot do that. Okay. Like supply of narcotics drugs. Cannot be sold. Okay. You cannot sell. Therefore, it cannot be considered as supply. So this is prohibited. So then what will happen with him? They will arrest him, they will put him in jail, they will take fine, penalty, whatever they have to do. They will not collect GST on that. Hello? On illegal activity, they will collect GST. So just for your reference, you should keep in mind, illegal activities are taxable under GST because it is a business. Business can be legal as well as illegal. But prohibited activity, you cannot run as a business. You cannot. Hello? Because it is prohibited by law. Yes or no? Okay. So this example they have given. Can we go ahead?
Yes.
Not that important though. Liquidator. Okay. Mr. X, an official liquidator. What is the job of liquidator? When company goes into liquidation, he sells those assets. Yes or no?
Yes.
And then he will take some his commission. So whether he is running business as a liquidator?
Yes.
Yes. Will he charge consideration?
Yes.
Yes. Whether his activity is subject to GST? Yes. Under which section? 7-1A. Okay, so his brokerage will be taxable under 7-1A. Next. So many examples they have given. Why these many examples? Because we are new into the law. Law itself is a new law, and then for law wanted everyone to understand. Okay, every word have this meaning. Although these examples are so low, like right now you might be feeling, sir, obviously no, this is business. No, sir. What? Why are you discussing? Okay, these obvious things are now because you are having that foundation of law. Sections are there in your mind. If you are going to study this for the first time in your life, then these examples would have helped you to understand law in a better sense. Okay, but right now we know this is a business, this will be taxable, so we are not feeling that burden because we know law. Okay, next. Mr. A, being a dealer of furniture, delivered the goods to branch office of Mrs. X Limited upon direction of X Limited head office. Okay, supply of furniture between Mr. A and X Limited head office, you tell me. Is it a supply?
Yes.
Furniture is sold.
Yes.
Yes. So, why? Because it is in the course of business and consideration is there. Obviously, it is taxable. Now, please understand, consideration need not to be paid by recipient. Need not to be paid. Right now, you are attending the lectures. But consideration for this is paid by your father. Still, we will charge GST, you know. Consideration can be paid by branch or consideration can be paid by head office. Who pays consideration, that is not important. Consideration should be there.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Consideration should be there. Who is receiving service may pay or may not pay. Like in your example also, you are receiving services but consideration is paid by parents. Yes or no? Alright. So consideration can also be paid by third party.
7-1A.
All these are 7-1A. Goods sent on demonstration on returnable basis, is it supply? Now demonstration means if I wanted to check new projector here because this projector is not working properly, say for example, so I will ask this guy, go and buy new projector, and first before buying it, tell them we wanted to see whether it is working or not working, because it's a 40,000 50,000 commodity. We will not just buy and check it. First we will check it and then we will buy it. So that shopkeeper is bringing that particular commodity here to check. You tell me, is it a supply? Now is it a supply?
No.
No, it's a movement of goods, but is it a supply?
No.
Did he sell it to me, transfer it to me? No, he's just bringing here to check, demonstrate. You understand? That this is how the product will work. That's not supply. Why? First of all, there is no consideration. Will he charge consideration now? obviously no. So consideration is also not there, and transfer of ownership is also not there, or sale is not there. It's not barter, it's not license, it's not rental. Hello, it's not supply. It just is bringing the goods here to show me. Yeah, if I take it here, then it will become supply. Yes or no?
Yes.
All right. So no, it would not be considered as supply, as there is no transfer of title involved. There is no transfer of title, and there is no consideration also. Both points are not there. Yes or no? All right. So this is not a supply. Why not a supply? Because 7.1A requires two things. It has to be supply, such as sale, transfer, barter, exchange. All right. In the course of business or furtherance of business for consideration. So you will write both, and you will say there is no transfer of title involved. Therefore, this is not a supply. Not a supply. When you say it is not a supply, still you have to refer under which section it is not a supply. So under which section it is not a supply? Under 7.1A, it is not a supply. Yes or no? And in deemed supply, 7.1C, we did not have any situation like this. There are only four specific situations where activity without consideration can be considered as supply. This activity was not there. Okay? Can we go ahead? Yeah. Next. Mr. A is the owner of Xerox machine. He transferred the right to operate Xerox machine to Mr. B for a consideration of 10,000 per month for 4 months. Hello, ownership is not transferred. Ownership is with me only. I'm just asking you, you can use my Xerox machine for 4 months and pay me 10,000 per month. Rental. Rental is supply.
Yes.
Is it supply of goods or is it supply of service?
Yes.
I'm giving you Xerox machine, but without title.
Yes.
So supply of service or supply of goods?
Yes.
Supply of service. Taxable or not taxable?
Yes.
Taxable. Okay. Leviable to? Leviable and taxable is the same word. I hope you understand. It is leviable. Okay. 7.1A. Barter. Do you remember my example of barter?
Yes.
Barter means commodity to commodity. We exchange commodities. Okay. Need not to be same commodity. So let's look at the example. Mr. C, a practicing cost accountant, provides services to A Limited, dealer of laptop. In return, A Limited given to Mr. C two laptops. So what is happening? You are a cost accountant, you are giving your services to company, and company in exchange, without, they are not giving you money, they are giving you laptop. First of all, you tell me whether the activity performed by you is in the course of business.
Yes. Yes.
Activity performed by A Limited is also in the course of business. So both people will pay tax. You will also pay tax, he will also pay tax.
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Tax paid by you will be available as ITC to them. Tax paid by them will be available as ITC to you.
Yes.
Hello? In normal sale transaction, two party cannot pay tax. Why? Because I am paying money and then taking, the one party is providing services. Here what is happening? One party is providing services, second party is providing goods. So there are two supply, there are two different supply. Supply of service, supply of goods, and both are taxable.
Yes.
Hello? Am I clear with this?
Yes.
Sure? Barter. Now you will say, sir, consideration is not there. Is it?
No.
Consideration is there or it's not there?
Yes.
It's there, but it is not in monetary form, it is in non-monetary form. Am I clear? So we have consideration. Can I go ahead? Supply or not a supply?
Supply.
Supply. Taxable under 7.1A. Okay. Next, dealer in laptop. You see, here it is clearly written. It will be paid by both parties. Yeah. Did you underline that?
Yes.
GST will be payable by both parties. There are two supply. No, two transaction is taken place. Okay. Mr. X, a dealer in laptop, he supplied a laptop for 40,000 to Y along with a barter of printer. Barter of printer means he has taken printer, taken 40,000 and then gave laptop.
Yes.
So there are two considerations here.
Yes.
Monetary
and non-monetary.
The value of printer known at a time of supply is 4,000. But open market value of laptop is not known. So laptop value I don't know, but I know value of printer. So you gave me printer and 40,000. I don't know laptop value. So what will I do? I should pay tax on what amount? I have asked you this question earlier also. You came to my shop along with your printer. You gave me printer. We decided price for printer 4,000 rupees. And then you paid 40,000 in cash.
Yes.
All right. So tax should be charged on what? And in exchange, I gave you laptop. Come on, tell me. 44, 40 or 4?
44.
44. Why 44? Because 40 is the monetary consideration, and 4,000 is a non-monetary consideration. Am I clear? So tax will be paid on 44,000. Yes or no? Understood? Easy?
Yes.
This type of questions will come for 2-3 marks. Unnecessary, we were putting too much of brain into understanding law, no? You came to my shop, I sell laptop. You came along with printer. Hello? You gave me your printer and you said I want laptop. Now printer to laptop is like non-feasible transaction, no? You gave me just printer worth rupees 4,000, you are asking the laptop. I don't know price of laptop. But I took 40,000 extra from you. So you gave me two components, two consideration. Monetary? Monetary how much? 40,000. And non-monetary printer? So I will give you laptop? No, now I have to pay tax on laptop. I don't know value of laptop. So how much value can you see?
44.
So should I charge tax on 40 or 44? This is the question. 44, because consideration can be monetary as well as non-monetary. Then next is exchange. Mr. A is the dealer of phones. He supplied for 20,000 rupees to B along with exchange of old phone. Now here what is happening? This is exchange. This is not barter. You are bringing phone and taking new phone. So he had charged 20,000 and barter of old phone was there. If the price of new phone without exchange is 24,000, the open market value of new phone will be 24,000. Are you getting this? So new phone value is 24,000. I gave you for 20,000. Why? Because you are giving me your old phone. So again my question is same. Should I charge GST on 24,000 or 20,000? 24,000, because there are two considerations. Monetary 20 and non-monetary old phone 4,000. So that is there. A dealer in new cars. He sells new car for 8,25,000. This is the market value of that car. Okay. And agrees to reduce 1,25,000 on surrendering old car. Mr. Y, who intends to buy new car worth rupees 8,25,000, agreed to exchange his old car to new car. Again, you tell me. He will take tax on 8,25,000 for sure. Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Supply. License. License, is it a transfer license? Giving license, is it a transfer?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Mr. Y developed a information technology software. So somebody has developed information technology software and holder of license thereon. He hold that license also. License to use software was given to different clients for rupees 18 lakh. Come on, tell me. License was given. Is it a supply?
Yes.
Giving license is a business. It is a supply. And for a consideration, 7 money, it is taxable under GST. 18 lakh will become taxable. Okay. Now, Chennai-based company has been awarded mineral exploration contract for 18 months in respect of specified sites in Mumbai by Mumbai-based corporation, local authority. Okay. So there is a Chennai-based company, and Chennai-based company applied for bidding, and Mumbai corporation have given them one contract. Okay, in this area you can do exploration. So they have right to do exploration. You understand exploration? Exploration means digging and, you know, extracting minerals from earth. Okay. As a result, Chennai-based company got license to extract mineral exploration for a period of 18 months. Mumbai-based company supplied taxable services. So Mumbai-based company, is it that Mumbai-based company, is it supplying any taxable services? I'm giving them license to explore mining. Yes or no?
Yes.
Mumbai corporation is giving license. Do you think it will be given for free?
No.
No. They will charge consideration. So is it a supply?
Yes.
Yes, it will be taxable under 7-1A. Mr. A owns a residential building in a prime commercial locality. Large vacant land is in background, given on rent for 1,80,000 per month to a parking contractor. This is the question. There is a house and there is a very big place behind my house which is given to parking contractor. Okay, so parking contractor will give me fixed for how much? 1,80,000, and then parking contractor will charge 5 rupees, 10 rupees, 20 rupees from the people who are parking their vehicle. For me it is fixed 1,80,000. Should I charge GST on 1,80,000? This is the question.
Yes.
I did not sell my land to him. It is the rental.
Yes.
Rent is a supply?
Yes.
Yes, rent is also supply, and this is in the course of business or furtherance of business, and he is getting consideration. Okay. Mr. X is the owner of a residential building in a commercial locality. Ground floor is given on rent to Y for a monthly rent of 60,000. Now there is an exemption, okay. And why is using this particular for residence? You know, while giving you example, I gave you example of commercial premises, because the residential premises exempt. That exemptions we have not studied, because so many people are staying in rent, but we don't pay GST on rent. Why we don't pay GST on rent? Because there is an exemption notification which says residential building used for residential purpose is not taxable in law. It is exempt. I told you now. Right now, see, we are done with all other negative. We are done with negative list. We are done with money and securities. We are done with alcoholic liquor for human consumption. We know petrol is not taxable. The only last 80-85 points are pending, which are exemption notification. One of the exemption notification is residential building given for residential purpose is not taxable in GST law. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Therefore, it is not taxable. Because of exemption, it is not taxable. Specifically exempted from GST. It is a supply, but it is exempt supply. Hello? Supply, but it is exempt supply. Okay? Can I go ahead?
Yes,
next. Mrs. M Bank Limited given an asset under finance lease to Mrs. N Limited. Repayment of finance lease is made by customer to bank for 80 lakh, which includes principal amount 50 lakh. You tell me, lease is taxable or not taxable?
Yes,
it is taxable. So it is taxable service. No problem. Liable for tax. Okay. Example 18. Alia Travels Limited, agent booking ticket for customer Z. Travel agent registers invoices on customer Mr. Z for transportation of passenger by air for 10,000, and his commission is 500. His commission is 500 and he is charging
10,000.
Then why this is not charging?
Why are
you? One second.